I've been waiting for this. Hello? Hello? Hi! Oh! Is this thing on? Can you hear me? New sorceress, who this? Who this? Hello! Hi! What's everybody up to? Hi! Oh! Oh, it's just my ears. Hold on a minute. Hi. Which way is this supposed to... Am I supposed to go up or am I supposed to go down? I'm not sure which way I'm supposed to go, but hello, everybody! Hi. It's me. It's your girl, Cersei Caster. I know, I'm a little short today. I need to put my shoes on. Yes. One moment. Well, hello, everybody. Thank you so much for the follows. Wow, there's so many of you here. Hello! Hi! Also, thank you, Kieran, for the raid. Thank you as well. Casey, my parents is here! Everybody, say hi to Casey. Say hi to Casey. Oh, give me a second. Hold on. Okay. I promise. Okay, now you see me? Now you don't. Okay, give me one moment. One moment. Hello? Hope everybody is doing well. Can you hear me? You all can still hear me, even though I cast an invisibility spell right now. I hope that's okay. So, something's happening here. Oh, something's happening here. Yo, thank you so much for the gift subs. Hi, everybody. Holy shit. Hi, thank you so much. Meowdy. Meowdy, everybody. Wait, yo, y'all.
I've been waiting for this.
Thank you for the generosity. Thank you for everybody's generosity. Oh, shoot. I got this. Okay, sorry. I'm turning off the invisibility spell. Thank you so much for the follows, everybody. Holy moly. Okay, wait. I'm going to catch up on the... Okay, alrighty. I know, I'm going to take off the invisibility spell in a moment. But hold on, let me catch up to everything. Holy moly. So most alerts are going to be turned off temporarily. You'll see some stuff in chat. But the visual stuff will show up in a bit, okay? I promise. But thank you so much, Sweet Blossom Flower 12 for the follow. Narky, thank you so much for the resub. Rose, thank you so much for the resub. Ginger, thank you for the follow. Jumia, thank you for the follow. Sukidora, Doragon Okami, thank you so much for the follow. Nick Moon Koss, Lynn, thank you so much for the follow. Ojimaru, thank you so much for the resub. Oh my god, 10 months. Casey, my parent is here. Thank you, Ojimaru, for the gift subs. Kira, thank you for the gift subs. Mama Petra, thank you so much for the follow. Copy Kira, thank you so much for the follow. And thank you for the 100 bits, Copy Kira. And then, thank you, Anonymous, for gifting a tier 1 sub to Aaron Soul. Holy shit, everybody. Hi. Okay, alrighty. I'm turning off the invisibility spell. Hold on. No? Okay, hold on. Alright, let me know if you see anything. Sorry, I turned my stuff upside down. It's been a while since I did this spell, so it's been a while. Sorry, I learned this from my favorite Catboy. I learned this invisibility floating. I guess this is also a floating spell. I suppose I should say, yeah, just my shoes. Okay. I guess we'll do the reveal. Bottom down. Bring back the ears. What? Also, thank you everybody for coming to my debut. Give us the grippers. The what? Oh, okay. Hold on. Thank you so much, everybody. We're gonna do this. Y'all see? Yeah. Then I guess I cast my invisibility spell wrong, but it also made me float. So I guess this is how we're gonna do the reveal. But okay, y'all see my feets? Hi everybody. Alright, hold on. Alright, hello? Okay. I'm gonna descend downward. Hold on. Oh, where's my music? My music's gone. There we go. I'm swinging from the chandelier. Oh my god, I hope I didn't break your voice. Sorry, everybody. I had vocal lessons today, so I'm just singing from the chandelier. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm defying gravity. But yeah, look. Swinging down. I'm a feet tuber now, everybody. Just kidding. Y'all, I'm giving you these feet for free. It's okay. Casey worked hard on this. For free, I know, right? For free? For free? Oh my god. Okay, I know, I know, I know. Alrighty. Alright, it's kind of getting tiring, a little swinging from the chandelier a little bit, so I'm just gonna drop down. A little bit more. There we go. Hello, hi everybody, it's me. It's hello. Episode Cersei Cast Razor, episode 1 and Angel Descends. Oh my god, wait. I need to show you. I need to show you everybody. I need to show you something. Hold on. Okay, 1 second. Oh, sorry. Thank you. Everybody, you should check out Casey. Music loud. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me go ahead and lower the music. Okay, thank you. Thank you for letting me know. But yeah. Hello. It's me. Also, I need to show you this cool thing. Hold on. Let me see if I can show you this. Hold on. Where is this? That's too close. I'm so sorry. Hello. I'm sorry for like for sorry, it's my face. Oh shoot! Ah, what who's throwing stuff at me? Hey. Invisible things are being thrown at me. Oops. Extreme close up. Okay, hold on. Is this better? Yeah, this is better. This is better. This is much better. Okay, awesome. Awesome sauce. Okay. Alright. So, I gotta show you this. Hold on. So, yeah, invisibility spells also affected the gift subs. Holy moly, but thank you so much. So, thank you so much, Honest Fowl, for gifting 5 tier 1 subs. Thank you so much. Holy moly. Hi, everybody. Okay, yeah, the close-up. Also, hold on. Let me scoot back a little bit. Sorry, a little bit too close. A bit too close. Let me scoot back just a little bit. There we go. Yeah. Okay, that's a little better. I gotta show you something cool that my parent AC did. Oh, this one? It's this one. I think it's this one. Cool. Pretty sure it's this one. This one? Oh, no, not that one. Too bright. That one. Yeah! So, I glow a little bit, and then my cape. Cape. You can see the stars a little bit better. Yeah! Mm-hmm. So, Casey did a really good job. And plus, you can see the blue of my eyes a little more. Yes. Okay. Thank you. Cutie alert. I know, right? And plus, you all get to see my ponytail now. You couldn't see it before, but... Oh. It's so much fun. Oh, right, the twins. I forgot. Sorry, these are for Grahatia Pillow Talk. I mean, what? I didn't say anything. Okay. I didn't say nothing. I didn't say anything at all. Nothing sussy whatsoever. Nothing sussy whatsoever. Nothing sussy whatsoever. Alrighty. Alrighty, so we're gonna turn the lights back on. Is it being sussy? No, it's a Tuesday. Sussy things happen on Wednesdays. That's why I don't stream. I don't stream on Wednesdays. This is her affirmative purse mark on her VTuber career. Love that for Raisin After Dark is after the lights go out. Oh no. Well, maybe. We'll see. Yeah, the Eeyore eyes, one small, one large is great. Thank you. They kind of just, they do what they want. Kind of like my spells. Alrighty. Yeah, those are the eyes that Graham will see at the span at the middle of the night. Oh no. He's used to it. It's fine. I guess. Alrighty, you're right. Okay. Before I pounce, excuse me, with consent. I only pounce if he consents. Anyway. Alrighty. Okay, alrighty. Do you all want to see some cool stuff? With the model before I get into the PowerPoint? What say you? What say y'all? Yes? Okay, alrighty. Since we were talking about Grahatsia, I get to show this. Okay, ready? Is this the caramel dancing? alrighty. Since we were talking about the Grahatsia, I think y'all are gonna love this. Alright, ready? 3, 2, 1. Ta-da! Did you expect anything less from me? Honestly, did you? The pillow! I love him!
I've been waiting for this!
And then also, oh, not that one. Oops, my bad, too many arms. I pulled a Doctor Strange, I'm so sorry. I pulled a Doctor Strange, I'm so sorry. Oop. Yeah. Also, this is my pillow. I pulled a Doctor Strange, I'm so sorry. In another life I learned from him. I don't know, what universe are we in? What universe is the MCU in, honestly? I don't know. Emotional support body pillow. Yeah, this is my favorite. I love this. Thank you so much, Casey, for doing this. This is fun. I love this pillow. Oh man, I love it. Love him. The pillow is amazing. I know. There's a little bit of physics too. Look at it. Alrighty, so he's gonna disappear now. I got some other stuff to show you. Alrighty. It was really, really fun to make. Oh, I'm glad. I'm glad that you loved it. I know, the pillow just like floats down to my arms, and then I just, yeah. Yeah, the pillow has physics too. It's amazing. I love it. And then also, you saw this earlier when I pulled a Doctor Strange, but, Oh, here we go. There's my staff. Where's my weapon? Kinda looks familiar, huh? Swoosh! Yeah. I love this, yeah. My outfit's very Disney princess. Yeah! Thank you! Yeah, the staff is perfect for bonking, but I don't know. Who actually gets bonked? Me? Or y'all? Questionable. Stay tuned and find out. Mm-hmm. Oh, hey, I don't think my bunk works. Hold on.
I've been waiting for this.
Yeah, some of my alerts are still turned off temporarily, up until the PowerPoint stuff. Hello, hey. Oh. Hi. Bayonetta, hi. Hello, everybody. Okay, so where's the staff? Hold on. Okay. Well, This one, honestly, like, you would have expected this because I am a controller player. Aha! Yeah, and it actually works too. You'll get to see it later when we play Cult of the Lamb. Yeah. I promise, you'll see it later. Mm-hmm. Hello! Hi, everybody who just came in. Hello, welcome to my debut stream! My alerts are turned off temporarily, I'm so sorry, but don't worry, they'll be back up soon. Yeah! Yes, a fellow Final Fantasy XIV player who plays on controller. Yes, I do play on controller. I've been playing Final Fantasy on controller for many, many years now. I think, what year is it? I started playing in 2014. Not 20... Oh, it's almost 9 years. Yeah, 9 years. Yes. Oh, thank you, Zenkei. Yeah. I actually encourage people to play on controller if they wish. I actually, half of my static. Yeah, if it's PC with controller, yeah. Yeah. I've been playing for a very long time. I went from PC to console and the Mac to PC. Mm-hmm. Alright, so I'm gonna put this away real quick. And then... oh, I gotta do some wine stuff. Controller boys unite, yeah! Actually, I think most of the static... most of my static now is controller. Maybe it's half and half, I don't know, I need to ask. Remind me to ask.
I've been waiting for this!
Okay, but also... If you all have been here for a while, you all know this is coming. Also, if you're new here, welcome everybody. This might also tell you the kind of person that I am. 1 second. Can I move up a little bit closer? Oh, okay, there. A little bit closer. Yeah. Okay. There we go. Alrighty. Here we go. I got my wine glass! And then also, this is how happy I get when I have my wine! Yeah! So sparkly. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the wine, yes! Is it rosé? Yes, it's a rosé. Also a Moscato, could be a Moscato. Mm-hmm. I like my lighter drinks, but yeah. I should just probably say I'm more of a wine aunt. A wine aunt than a mom. At least that's what I. You know that scene in Mean Girls where the mom goes, "I'm like that cool mom" or whatever. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I'm that. I might just be the aunt. So I'm related to her, but I'm. But I'm giving no. Mother energy, no. Couldn't be me, not at all. Nope. But I guess if I hard denial, you know? I guess that points out to it. Yeah. Before I went plant-based, I was very much a wine sum. Oh, no! A good wine is nice, after a hard day. Auntie energy, yes. I aspire to be wine aunt energy. Okay. Alrighty, did I miss any? I think those are the main ones. Okay. You wanna... oh my gosh, okay. Alrighty. Okay, so I am going to actually keep my glass of wine with me. Are we ready to go to the PowerPoint portion? Yes, I think we are ready for the PowerPoint portion. Okay. Alrighty. On a second. Okay, one moment. Let's go. Remember how to do this. It's been a hot minute. So sorry. Okay, oh, that's not it. Wait, is that it? Oh, yes, that is. Okay, awesome! I figured it out! Okay, alrighty. Are you ready for the PowerPoint? Okay, cool. If not, that's okay. Don't worry about it. Oh, I disappeared! That's fine. Alrighty, hi everybody. Welcome to my debutante ball. Oh, it's loud? Oh, I'm so sorry. It's so loud. It's loud again. I'm so sorry. Welcome to my debutante ball. Welcome, everybody. Please enjoy my graphic design is my passion. JPEG, right here. In Filipino culture, a debut is called a debut. So welcome. I'm so sorry the music's low. Okay, so this is actually a movie cover. If you all know who Dante Bosco is, he is the voice actor for Zuko in Avatar: The Last Airbender. He was also Rufio in Hook, and he's in this movie. And so I put my face over. This is actually version. This is version what? 1.0. This is version 1.0 of me with Graha and Emmerich. So welcome. Anyway, that's not. Don't worry. This isn't the full PowerPoint. I promise. This isn't the full PowerPoint. Okay. Now, Rufio. Oh my God. Also, hello. Oh, so smutty. Where is the control for this thing? Hold on. Okay, I'm turning this music down. Turning the other one up. Oh Lord. Okay. Okay. Is the other one fine? Alrighty. Well, we'll get to our bread and butter now. We'll get to the bread and butter now. Okay. Alrighty. Thanks everybody for bearing with me. I'd be fine if this was the whole PowerPoint. I promise this is not the full PowerPoint. There's still quite a bit to go. Okay. Alrighty. So. It thinks I'm on the other tab. Okay. Yeah! Thank you everybody for coming to my 2.0 debut. My 2.0 reveal. Thank you so much. We're gonna use the hashtag Cersei time from now on for my live going live posts. I actually forgot to do it today. I just wrote it automatically. But I hope you loved the lovely artwork. It was made by Etroveria. Etroveria is a Final Fantasy XIV artist who I've commissioned and wanted to commission them for a long time. They drew some amazing Wolship, so Warrior of Light and Emmerich fan art that I saw through a mutual friend of mine. And so I've always wanted to commission them and I finally got to, so you'll see a lot of this art piece around. You also saw it at the starting scene screen and some of the future screens. Alrighty. And then, of course, next slide. I've been waiting for this! I've honestly been waiting to show a 2.0 version for if you've been here before.
I've been waiting for this.
I was streaming with a lovely Vroid model that some friends of mine made for me, and I love it to pieces. But I wanted to have a design that was, you know, specifically me, and so here we are, the Grand Sorceress. Alrighty, and continuing on, who am I? I am Cersei Caster, also known as Raisna. You can call me either or. I will respond to both, I promise. I am a grand sorceress who made a bet with the gods in order to spare the universe from destruction. I want to find more heroes to tip the balance away from darkness before the end of my 9 lives. My age is redacted. If you know how old I am. No, you don't. My birthday is September 19th. I'm 5'9". Or am I? It's the shoes, huh? It's the shoes. Shoes. I don't want to know. I don't want to know how much this gives me. Also, my languages, I speak native English and then Tagalog. I have very, very limited vocabulary. Very, very limited vocabulary. There's only a few words you'll hear me say every so often. But I would love to go back and learn more Tagalog and other languages. I'm actually currently learning Japanese as well. Through Duolingo, I have like a 44-day streak. So after stream, I really have to remember to actually do my Duolingo streak. So everybody, remind me. Age is a number. Don't worry about it. Of course, it's just a number. Alrighty. And so, moving on. Look at this lovely art by Maria Agidine, also known as Bayonetta, who's here in chat today. Alrighty, my Oshi marks are a snowflake and stars, any variations of stars. my general tag is going to be hashtag Cersei Caster, which is actually the name of my Warrior of Light. We share the same name. Huzzah! And so it'll actually be easier for folks to find me in Final Fantasy XIV and other games, because most likely I'm going to use the same. My live tag is going to be hashtag Cersei Time. My general art is going to be hashtag Cersei Folio. Oh, Rainbow Table, thank you so much for the follow. If there's any spicy art, like 18 up, maybe adult-like, maybe, the hashtag is going to be only spots. Not sure if it's going to be used very often, but made one just in case. The community is still going to be the Queensglaive, so we do have a Discord also named the Queensglaive, and so everybody in chat and the community members are going to continue to be called the Queensglaive. There are going to be lore reasons for that that I will disclose at a later time. Don't worry, it'll be in the future lore video that I'm going to have, which I do not have today, but I will have in the future. Clips, I haven't decided if it's going to be Cersei Tales, like actual like cat tale, or just regular tales, like story tales. I haven't decided that. What do you all think? Matter? And then also, I was gonna leave it up to you all to help me with a meme tag. I don't have a... Rose? Cersei Circus? Oh no. Oh no. Okay, I need to write that one for the book. Hashtag Cersei Circus. Oh, Clown Caster Cersei Circus. That's... Oh no, that's so good. That is so good. Oh my god, Rose, that's perfect. Circus like the Vegas Hotel. Oh no. Oh no, that's so good. These are so good. Okay, I'm gonna write this down. Okay. Okay. I would edit the PowerPoint, but I don't want you to see everything that's on the rest of this PowerPoint. Okay, alrighty. So, I'll write that down. Edits PowerPoint live on stream. I mean, I can, but I'm not going to. No, you're not gonna see what's on my screen. Okay. Yeah. Just use a marker and write on your monitor. I don't... Hide live edits. Hide magic cursor. You know what? It's fine. Don't worry. Let me just write Circus. Okay, I wrote it down. I wrote it in cursive. C-I-R. It's fine. I'm just... Okay. Alrighty. Thank you for your marketing experience. Oh god, oh. What did I do? Hello? Okay. Alrighty. So, likes. Of course, you all know I like Rahatia. I like retro games, PS2 era games. There was a debate for a while whether or not PS2 was considered retro or classic. The retro folks won. Also, I love Jollibee. I love Chicken Joy and Spaghetti. I absolutely love Jollibee. I haven't had it in weeks, and by God, I need to go get Jollibee this week. Hey, Kieran? Kieran, we're getting Jollibee this week. Okay, thanks, bye. I love Hokkaido milk tea and mango green tea. So those are my go-to drinks. Anytime I go to a bubble place, if the place is known for their milk teas, I'll get a Hokkaido milk tea or something close to it. Or I'll get if they're for fruit teas, I'll lean towards the mango. Okay. And then I love shabu shabu with friends. Usually all you can eat shabu is great. Spontaneous adventures with friends. There were like, what, 2 weeks in a row that I went to a revolving sushi bar with someone here in chat, like twice in a row. Just saying. And then rope dropping certain theme parks. I like going to theme parks. I am that person who would go at like opening time with an itinerary and just have plans and know how to maximize my day. Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you. My food tastes are impeccable. Thank you. Thank you. So those are a few of my likes. Also, if you see this lovely emote here, this is by Giru Tofu, who is here. I saw you earlier, Giru Tofu. I saw you. I didn't miss you. I promise. Hold on. Let me give you a shout out. Oh, what did I do? Hold on. Invisible things are hitting me. And then also, I do need to shout out Bayonetta too. I do need to shout out Bayonetta. I will do this. Promise. Okay. Alrighty. So we're gonna continue. Hello, friends. I see more of you. Hello. Okay. Alrighty. So, continue. PowerPoint. Hello? Okay, there. Okay. So my dislikes. Since we covered my likes, we'll cover my dislikes. So, I don't like horror games. But there's a lot of horror games I will not play. There are two that I'm going to play on stream. They're not Resident Evil. They're something else, I promise. So horror games, no go. Horror games, no go. I don't like bugs. Spiders. Ladybugs scare me. Butterflies scare me. Oh my god. I went to a monarch butterfly sanctuary once when I was younger. And it was like the start of migration season. And my mother... Cersei mama, raised a mama, went into the sanctuary. It was like, oh, it'll be fine. And I'm like, no, mother, no. So my sibling and I, we went in after her and we ran out. We promptly ran out because we saw the monarchs just get off the branches and start moving. All together. That was not good. That was actually terrifying. Yeah, it was terrifying. They're pretty to look at. Not gonna lie, they are pretty to look at. Just, I don't want to be there in person. I personally can't be there in person. So yeah. And then after that, we did go to Jollibee. We went to Jollibee. That cheered me up. But that's the segue into my next dislike. They took away the breakfast menu at Jollibee. I used to get their tocino and their garlic fried rice in the mornings. If I woke up early enough, I would go to Jollibee and be like, oh, I don't want to cook. Okay, so let me go get breakfast. And so they took it away. They took it away. So I was like, that's not good. And then also, speaking of things that get taken away, when my favorite theme park takes away my favorite adult beverage, they took it away. And yes, going to theme parks, I like going to theme parks, but I don't like the aftermath, the consequences of my actions the next few days. That's what I don't like about it. And I dislike writing this section because I didn't know what else to write here. Yeah, what was good on their breakfast menu? I honestly got the same thing every time. It was the tocino and garlic rice. How would you describe tocino? It's like... Gosh, how would you describe it? Filipinos in chat, you're here. Can you help me describe that? I don't... Yeah, they had tocino. Like, hey, Bayonetta, can you describe what tocino is? Because I'm struggling here. I'm trying to find words for it. Yeah. Yeah, it's like a sweet... Oh, sweet sausage. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Have a good night, Mama Petra. Have a good night, sibling. Also, hello. M's here. Hello, M. I see you. Okay, we're gonna move before I get distracted. I'm gonna get distracted again, honestly. Okay. Alrighty. Okay. Also... Now, moving on, since we're still talking about, like, things I like. My favorite music, honestly, it's all over the place. Like, I don't have a consistent genre that I, like, stick with. It's, like, K-pop, it's video game music, it's variations of pop. I guess there's some pop punk, I don't know what you call it. So yeah, the Whiplash, like, I came into K-pop second gen with, like, Shiny, Super Junior, TVXQ, Girls' Generation, BoA, Rain, and all them. And then on the flip side, like if you go to like Western music, I'll listen to like Linkin Park's older stuff. I didn't really get into their newer stuff. Britney Spears is my queen, and Evanescence. Yeah, yeah. The what sounds good method, I can appreciate. And like honestly, like I'll be real with you all. I discovered a lot of Western music through anime music videos. So if certain anime music videos had the same song over and over again, then the song was like, I consider the song really good, like Bring Me to Life, In the End, Breaking the Habit, Numb, you know, all of those songs. If I hope I'm not the only one who has done that. That's how I discovered music. A lot of my music tastes have been formed because of AMVs. Yeah, the golden age of Naruto AMVs, 2008. AMVs are so good. That's how I discovered a lot of music. That's a good one too. Yeah, every time we touched by Cascada. What is the one song that stayed with me the longest? Definitely Bad Boy by Cascada. Bad Boy was one of them. What was the other one? Oh god, there was another one. Every time we touch is also another one, but there was like Bumblebee, the DDR song also was one that stuck with me. Actually, I hear it. It haunts my dreams sometimes. It haunts my dreams. I'll be real with you all. Bumblebee's not Cascada, but like honestly, I feel like it's adjacent because it's close to that genre of music, I think. Or maybe I'm misremembering. I don't know. Yeah, yeah. Wait, Marotic was not on there. Oh, that's a crime. Marotic is such a good song. I love this song. I love that one. Okay, I'm gonna keep going before I get distracted again. Currently favorite shows. I could only think of these four. Once Upon a Time was pretty good up until like I forgot where. It's like, when you talk to a Once Upon a Time fan, you're gonna say like some seasons are good, some seasons are bad. Similar to like the Supernatural fandom, like after a certain season, like don't watch it. That's what I think about Once Upon a Time. Do not watch the last season of Once Upon a Time. Do not. It's I don't like it. And then I season two was one of my favorites of Once Upon a Time. Is Captain Hook. Colin O'Donoghue showing up as Captain Hook. Oh, yeah, exactly. The last season of Once Upon a Time does not exist. Exactly. But you know what does exist? The final season of Clone Wars, which hurts like a bitch. Because if you watch it side by side with Revenge of the Sith, holy moly. Oh, my heart. My heart. My heart. God. I knew when they announced the last season of Clone Wars, I knew exactly what was gonna, well, okay, not exactly what was gonna happen, but I knew it was gonna hurt. And it did. It very much so did. It hurts a lot. And so I also like that it did tie into Revenge of the Sith and like how they maneuvered through placements of things, because you could start watching Clone Wars and then pausing and then starting up like Revenge of the just side by side. It's amazing. And then Rebels is really good. Star Wars Rebels, if you get the chance to, it's really good. There are some episodes that my sibling and I have debated about the slow start of Rebels, but it does get really good. It does. And I actually finished it. She started before me, but I finished it for her. She needs to start up again. And so I do need to refresh my memory because the Ahsoka series is Rebels is Aladdin and I mean, you're not wrong. You're not wrong, Ginger. You're not wrong. And then they're all kind of fantasy. Like they're all like fantasy, space fantasy, and MMO. I'm trying to see a link here. There kind of is, kind of isn't. But Dad of Light, if you get the chance to watch Final Fantasy XIV, Dad of Light, I hope you get to. I got to watch this with my friends and my partner and a couple of other people, and it's really sad. Like, it makes me happy, but then also knowing what happened to the person who inspired Dad of Light and how he passed away a couple years ago, I'm like, oh no. But the story lives on. But I was sitting here every episode. I was like, hold on, why don't you just talk to your dad? But you know, I every episode I was like, is he going to tell his dad? Is he going to tell his dad? And like, you know, stuff happens. Keep watching. If you haven't seen it, just watch. I won't spoil the ending. Yeah. It's on Netflix. I think it's still on Netflix. Still on Netflix. If not, I'll find it. There's also a movie version, which I think is different. It's made by a different studio. I'm still trying to hunt down the movie version of... My partner does also play Final Fantasy XIV. He's on break from Final Fantasy XIV, but he usually plays whatever role opposite to me. So if I'm healing, he takes. If he heals, I either DPS or tank. Yeah, everyone's practically on break because of patch lull. But there are still some folks who, you know, still find ways to do stuff, you know? Okay. Alrighty. Four. I know. A month now? Oh, we're not done. Great. We're still talking favorites. Okay, who recognizes all these movies? Who recognizes these movies? These are my favorites. Atlantis, Treasure Planet, Howl's Moving Castle. I liked Princess Diaries 2 over Princess Diaries 1. The Mummy and The Mummy Returns. Oh my god, I love Mummy Returns. Also, Princess Diaries 2. I love this movie so much. The dynamic between Princess Mia and freaking Nicholas. I love that dynamic. Give me more of that in my fix. Good stuff. Oh yeah, Stan Lee was in it. That's right. Where's Rise of Skywalker? We don't talk about Rise of Skywalker, Rose. Remember? We don't talk about that fan fiction unless drinks are involved. And then my favorite one of Narnia was Prince Caspian. Ben Barnes. Ben Barnes supremacy right here. Ben Barnes. I almost started watching, what's that show? Westworld? Because Ben Barnes is in it. And then I started watching, what's that Netflix show? Shadow and Bone? Because Ben Barnes is in it. Now I'm hooked and I bought the book. So I'm diving into the book series. Yeah, of course Ben Barnes has to show up. And then also, a lesser known favorite of mine is Robin Hood Men in Tights. Lesser known favorite. Oh man, I love this movie. I love these movies. Manly men, men in tights, please talk to me about Shadow and Bone. I need to read the books first and then we'll talk. Yeah. You know, I've never seen Cats, and I don't know if I want to. I'm scared to watch the movie Cats. I'm scared. I binge watched season 2 of Shadow and Bone. Wait, did I? Oh no, I'm on the last episode, yeah. Next movie is Cats. Oh god, no. Oh my god, what are we gonna do? Puts that on, like, there's a whole growing list. Seer, there's a whole growing list. And also, I didn't want to put posters for favorite anime because we'd be here forever. But I feel like my boomer card might get revoked with some of these. Okay. You're learning so much. Well, that's what the stream's for, right? What it's for. Okay. Favorite anime and manga, because, well, there's overlap here, but there was a lot. Dian Angel has to be number one. Cardcaptor Sakura, Sailor Moon, Yu-Gi-Oh, of course. The season with Yugi and Kaiba. Kaiba's my favorite. Because I'm just gonna say this already. It's the I can fix him plus money bags. Yeah, and then Tsubasa Reservoir Chronicle, but that's so confusing. I don't even know what's happening there. I don't even know what's happening in the new manga that came out. Vampire Princess Miu, Code Geass, Lelouch of the Rebellion. I saw the movie Lelouch of the Resurrection, but in order to understand a lot of it, because there were changes, you needed to watch the first two movies that summed up the seasons, which I did not do. So I saw Resurrection and was like, what? What's happening? What? I don't understand. Death Note, I feel like is a classic. There was definitely a year where you saw a bunch of lights, L's, and Misa's running around. Gundam Seed. I know Gundam Seed is not everyone's favorite Gundam, but it was my first Gundam, so it there is one of my favorites. 00 was my second one. I actually wanted to cosplay Tyria Erde, but I didn't. I was going to, but did not. Star Driver is a lesser known one that folks are actually surprised at. I really liked Star Driver. Free Iwatobi Swim Club, I really, really liked. I dare you to guess my favorite character from Free. I dare you to guess. Macross Frontier also falls under the mecha anime. My dad got me into that one, actually. He was like, oh, here! I torrented these, watch it. It's pretty good. And I'm like, okay, dad. And it was really good. And so we were like, okay, dad, it's actually really good. Which version of Vampire Princess Miu? I actually don't know, Mars. I saw the DVDs at Blockbuster, so I actually don't know which version it was. Yeah. Only M got it right. My favorite from Free is Makoto. And I identify with Haru. I actually bought a statue of Makoto. Oh god, but I don't know where it is. I think my parents have it somewhere. But yeah, that's my favorite. He's very sweet. I love him. He's a sweet bee. And then you see the rest of my pipeline and go, Reizna. What the fuck? What? Hi. Hello? You picked this sweet boy, and then there's these guys. Don't worry. You might understand as we go along. But yeah. Probably it might be the OVA. And then there's Chrono Crusade. I followed the manga and the DVDs. I think I had all of them. And then, again, Howl's Moving Castle is on here, because it's movie and anime, studio, probably. Spy Family is one of them. Also, The Melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya. I almost stumbled and said the Melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya, which is a ice cream flavor at a local ice cream shop that I love to go to with my friends. And I like saying the full title because I can flex. And then Wotakoi, Love is Hard for an Otaku, which is a fun one. I almost bought the box set at a bookstore last weekend? No. Days are melding together. Almost bought that whole thing. Maid-sama is a fun one that I love. My favorite manga, Magic Knight Re:Earth. I was told the anime was so-so, so I never got around to it. There was a Kingdom Hearts manga, which I love. Love to death. It's so silly. It's so silly, but I love it. There's also Pilot Candidate, which I'm actually watching on Crunchyroll now. During my break, I started watching Pilot Candidate for Goddess. It's by the author of DN Angel, but they put it on indefinite hiatus when DN Angel picked up. And then there's Shaolin Sisters. I'm actually looking for copies of that. I had a set when I was younger, but ended up giving those away. So now I'm trying to rebuild my collection. Yeah, that's my favorite manga and anime. I hope you all have learned a lot. Ever read Yotsuba? And nope, I have not. Best SOS man. Oh my. Shoot. That's my favorite S. Oh my god. I'll have to come back to that one. Yotsuba To is how it's pronounced. Hey, 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 Kieran, stop! Stop! Does it? No, wrong. It is Kion because Crispin Freeman. It is actually because of Crispin Freeman. What about Code Lyoko? I have not seen Code Lyoko. Also, hi Siri! Also, hi Gab! Hello everybody!
Hi!
Oh my god, I'm like so red. Oh my god. Okay, alrighty, I'm gonna get to- we're not even halfway through! We're like on page- we are on page 12 now. So we're done with the favorites! We're done with the favorites. We're done. We're gonna move on to showing off, like, who the wait, Crispin Freeman wasn't Bayonetta 2? No. Wait, really? Oh, thank you for the posture check. Thank you. Oh, hey. Okay. Alrighty. Thank you for the... He plays her dad? He plays Bayo's dad? Oh no. Oh no, 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 we're... No. And then Luca is Yuri Lowenthal. Yeah, I knew that. I can hear that with Luca. Oh no. No. Oh god, no. It's for the heads. God. Okay. I haven't played it's okay. Oh no. Papa Bayo. I'm gonna scroll away. Also, Carissa66, thank you so much for the follow. Most alerts are still turned off. We're gonna continue on in this PowerPoint. Before I linger on that. Crispin Freeman is Bayo Daddy. Oh no. Oh no, no. What do I do with this information? What do I do? Like, hello? Thanks, Bayonetta. Alright. We're done with the favorites. We're done. We're gonna move on. And show everybody who's worked on our stuff. Mm-hmm. Sounds like a plan. Gaze upon the pipeline. I have no words. okay. the Krom to Grahatia pipeline. Where do I even start? I don't know where to start. Cause like, okay, so Sid Rains walked. So this could run. The Sid Rains to Emmerich to Grahatia. Okay, so the Sid Rains hold on. Invisibility spell. I'm sorry. Okay, I need to recenter myself. I need to recenter. I need to enter. Okay, I'm back. Okay. Okay. This world has been connected, tied to the darkness. Are these your emotional support husbandos? Okay, I don't know if Virgil would count as an emotional support husbando. He would just kill things. He falls in the I can fix him. He also, Albumnox also falls off, falls into the I can fix him. What's more emotional? Where does Vincent fit him? Oh, you know, he's just the, he's the webtoon stand-in because he's got the dark hair and red eyes. So if you read any Korean manhwa, he's the stand-in for any Korean manhwa. I'm kidding. How dare you slander him like this? Vincent is baby girl. Legitimate, why Zexion? Oh, Zexion comes in because there's this running joke that I had with some friends. They used to call him, like, what? Sexy Zexy or something? He was like that. Everybody I knew liked him. I was like, oh, okay. Me too. Oh my god, Vincent, the OG baby girl, the OG meow meow. Oh no. I've spoken this phrase back into existence. We're back in. When did Chain of Memories come out? 2004? 2005? We've been thrown back into the past, everybody. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. So sorry. But yeah. If you know me and my Fire Emblem, I love Krom. If you know me from Kingdom Hearts, I love Terra, I love Riku, I love Zexion. If you know me from Star Ocean, I love Albumnox. If you know me through Final Fantasy, there's Graha. Arbert's here. He's also standing for Meteor. And then there's Emmett Salk.
Never. You're mine!
You're welcome. I have thrown us back into the mid-2000s. You're welcome, Sireni. You're welcome, Sire. And then there's Kaiba.
Emotional damage!
Yeah, Terra. Excellent fighter, excellent friend, excellent husbando. Arbert was on the... Yes, Arbert has always been on the PowerPoint, Kieran! You just didn't see him beside Graha and Emmett Selk? Like... hides this one. Ah! It's also because I ship Arbert. I ship Arbert! With, like, one of my OCs. That's also why he's on here, technically. He's technically on here because of it. Alrighty. Alrighty, okay. Yeah, but is it Derplander, Ardbert, or Litibus? Good question. Good question. Which one? Hello? I did not know this. Minfina! Sir, it's Minfina! I ship Minfina with Ardbert. Also, then again, I ship, like, Minfina with, like, Diabolos. So, like, that's entirely left field. So, if you're wondering about the Diabolos thing, it's because my character plays Diabolos. My friend plays Diabolos. On Sargadanos. Love you. Love you, friend. And so, like, they had chemistry, and we were like, okay, we'll just roll with it. And so, good. So that's the whole Diabolos, Minfina Goddess of Love thing. Yeah, Void Scent. Void Scent thing. Because he exists in Final Fantasy XIV. Ships, right? They just grab you. They just grab you by the neck, and you have almost no say in it. Like how these. One look at all of these people and I went, oh no. Oh no, no, no. But alas, I have to look away. It's probably a blessing for all of you, but I have to click away from y'all. Click away from all of you. Also, you will see this one. You'll see Kanan. When I play Xenosaga Episode 3, he'll be there. He gets stepped on. Where's Jumin Han? He's your blueprint? Oh, right, I played Mystic Messenger. I couldn't find a nice picture of Jumin Han. That's why he's not there. do you have a character that's like, I can make him worse? Ooh. I have to come back to that one. I have to come back to that one. We'll find out. Graha? Isn't that Graha? I don't know. I don't know if that would be him. Jumin? Oh, Graha 100%. Oh, man. Okay. As much as I love staying on that screen, I have the rest of this PowerPoint to go through. But I'm gonna take you on a journey. I'm gonna take you on a journey through the journey of this channel. So the 1.0 model was made by No Longer Cappy, who I might have seen here earlier. They made my first model. This is actually the base model they made, and then I found some assets to strengthen the ears. And then my 1.0 logo was reminiscent of the Scholar Fair. I really liked it. It's really cute, and I think I still have some stickers of it. One of my favorite things. This is when I played Scholar a lot in Final Fantasy. And I was centered around streaming Final Fantasy XIV a little bit more. And then the 1.5 design, when I was a game streamer, this was made by Heiji Art. So that's Cersei, the Final Fantasy XIV version of Cersei. And then there's the 1.5 design by Melificar. Made the base design of what would become this model. I really liked what she was doing here. I really liked the blue of the eyes. So it transferred here as well. That everybody kept the blue. And then the 2.0 logo was made by Amaya Sin. So we leaned more into the Snow Leopard design. And so the Snow Leopard design continued with Rhea Valentine's design. She made this ref sheet for me. Definitely leaned more into the Snow Leopard here. And then more of the elegant gown design. And then got our magic staff here that you saw earlier. Sheesh, oh my gosh. You all are too sweet. And then the 3.0 logo, we definitely leaned into more of the magical name, Cersei Caster. I still will respond to Raza. Totally fine with me. And then there's me. Kuroha did the logo for me, and then Casey here, this model. Here, it's I love this model so much. I love this model so much. Thank you everybody. Thank you, Casey. And then here are the new emotes. I actually uploaded them here on Twitch a week ago. So if you are subscribed to the channel, you get to see a few more of these as well. They are made by Giro Tofu, who made a few of my emotes before. These are the new updated ones. I still do have emotes from Bayonetta here as well. A few of the follower ones as well, and then I think some of them are also made by Cheese, and there's one more. I'm totally blanking. It'll be here soon. I think I have like a list of everybody who whose assets I commissioned and or used. Oh, PowerPoint. Hello, PowerPoint. Okay, yes. Okay, so the overlays that you saw, so like the just chatting and the gaming screen, which is the one that we're on right now, is made by Ohio Kyo. Amazing work, would definitely recommend. It's very clean and I love it. I loved working with them. And then the art that you saw at the beginning was from Etro, and the Persona 5 assets are from Onikoga. Lovely person to work with. I still have a couple of my alerts. The Persona 5 critical hit alert from previously was also made by Koga. The music is by Dama, who I found because a lot of folks were commissioning Warrior of Light music themes from this person, and I really liked their work. Well, and I really like it. So I was like, oh, I want to just keep commissioning you, even just for like my Final Fantasy 14 themes. So hit them up. I do have links below in my About Me for all of these folks. And then we have emotes from Giro Tofu, Cheese, Maria Agudine, also known as Bayonetta here in chat, and Neskibo. Ness made the Grahatia Wave emote that we have. And welcome, Maelstrom Radios. Thank you so much for the raid. Hello, welcome, welcome, welcome. I hope you're having a lovely evening. The alerts are turned off right now. But I hope you're doing well. You're still doing my PowerPoint! And then the sub badge. Oh, actually, they're flipped! That is correct. Sub badges are made by Lavi Creative. They're the crystals of light that you see. And also, they do the channel points. My bits badges are also made by Amayasin. So you'll see that if you toggle on the bits badge. They're hourglasses. This lovely chat box is the Dark Moon chat box by Melon Turtle. The animation isn't done yet, but you'll see it later on, I believe next week. I'll have some animated overlay screens soon. So tune in next week and they'll be ready. The debut trailer was by Hez. Who's listed below as well. The stinger that you saw with my little chibi was made by Frostbite, also known as Axel. And then the schedule is made by CalPNT. And the progress bar that you see that is logging my car fund is made by by T-Cuppity. And actually, before I forget, I will Maelstrom Radio out. Alrighty. And so we're gonna move on from the credits. All the credits are also listed down below. So if there's any art that you want to check out, everybody's listed below. So emotes, overlays, artwork, they're all down there. Mm-hmm. So credit your artists, support your artists, everybody. Artists make the VTuber world go round. And thank you again, Casey. Thank you again, Bayonetta. Thank you again, Kira Tofu. And everyone else who's helped me get everything for today. Thank you, everybody. The future is terrifying, but I do have you all with me, and so we're going to talk about future plans for the channel and what happens next. Okay, so my goals are to have more fun, which you're definitely going to see. I'm going to be playing more games that I've been meaning to play or wanted to play for a very long time. I got my PlayStation 1 up and running, so I'll be able to play more retro games, and I'm very, very excited for that. I will be doing some more collabs with friends in the future. We do have one coming up soon, and I'm going to talk about that shortly. We're going to raise more money for charity. I'm going to be focusing on Extra Life because of my team. And then eventually I do want to become a Twitch partner and a YouTube partner. It's ambitious, I know, but I want to just check off that milestone and see if I can do it. Alrighty. And then I do have plans. We will have some Extra Life charity streams with my team, the Dandelions. The Dandelions are named after the Keyblade Bearers from Union Cross, Kingdom Hearts Union Cross. So we are a collective of content creators and friends who are banding together to raise money for our local children's hospitals in North America. Mm-hmm. And then I will be planning and making a set of vlogs for the North American Final Fantasy XIV Fan Fest 2023 in Las Vegas, so please look forward to that. I will be continuing to showcase more retro PS1 and PS2 games. Circling back to when I said I don't usually play horror games, the only horror games you're most likely going to see on this channel is going to be Parasite Eve 1 and 2. I do have physical copies of Parasite Eve 1 and 2, and so I will be playing those games for the month of October for Halloween season. For spoopy season. Yeah, I'm really, really excited. So, they're so good. I've wanted to play them. I most likely will not play the third one because PSP stuff. And plus, like, I've heard conflicting things about the third one, so definitely just one and two will be on the schedule. And then I do have other games like Xenogears, the Dot Hack games. I have Dot Hack, Infection, Mutation, and Outbreak. I'm still looking for Quarantine, so if anybody has an eye out for Dot Hack Quarantine, just let me know. Ping me in my Discord. Or ping me on Twitter if you see it. I'm also currently recording my first cover song, which I hope to release at some point this year. I'm also brainstorming for an original song. I used to write poetry and/or lyrics when I was younger, and so I do want to go back into that, so please look forward to it. And I will eventually have a future lore video once I get some things settled down. So, those are plans for right now. And then games that we were going to play, I did mention a few. Xenosaga Episode 3, Star Wars Jedi Survivor, Final Fantasy 14 patch content, Monster Hunter Rise would be sprinkled in there. Definitely Final Fantasy 16 would be something that I do play once it comes out. Persona 3 Portable and Cult of the Lamb and Hades will be sprinkled in every so often. PS2 games like Shadow Hearts Covenant and the original Shadow Hearts will be played as well. Final Fantasy Type-0 HD would be played as well at some point. Xenogears, Parasite Eve 1 and 2, Dot Hack Infection, Mutation, and Outbreak. Tachyville, hello, thank you. Oh my god, thank you. So luckily enough, did not have to pay an arm and a leg for Shadow Hearts and Shadow Hearts Covenant. Wild Seven Knights, my partner, actually still had his own copies of these, so I am borrowing them. So we actually saw how much they were going for at a local collectibles shop, and holy moly, that... Also, the same with Xenosaga 3. Xenosaga 3 is going for like 350. So I'm very blessed that I still kept my copy. So these are going to be the games that I will be playing in the future. Timeline will be a little weird, but this should cover the next year and a half, maybe 2 years. So please look forward to it. Alrighty, and then there's my schedule. Today, after the stream, I am going to stop stream and then restart stream to switch to Cult of the Lamb, and then go from there, just for archiving purposes. So we will be continuing the stream. We are going to play Touch Starve on Thursday, just because I wanted to play the demo as well. We are also playing Final Fantasy 14 on Saturday, the 22nd. We are going to be doing a subathon to raise money for the channel. This channel does now assist with my livelihood. It's helping with my mobility fund. So that's where the subathon money would be going to. It's my mobility, my new car fund. So thank you everybody for supporting me, whether it's you or a sub or bits. I really do appreciate it. So for the subathon, it is going to start at 10 a.m. Pacific Daylight Time. I did put standard time, but it's actually daylight time. So these are going to be some of the incentives and milestones. There was an addition to this. We're actually going to be giving away the music boxes, the Final Fantasy 14 music boxes for Flow and Mortal Instances. Wild Seven Knights and I actually accidentally purchased more music boxes. We already had a couple of them, so we have two music boxes of Flow and one of Mortal Instances that we will be raffling off during the subathon as well. So details are going to be on Twitter again, Twitter, Discord, and here on the channel. Yeah, Reason Becomes a Legend on... if I had people to teach me, maybe, and if I had time. It's you know, the triangle of things. But maybe one day. If there's a will, there's a way. Alright, so this is part two. If we do reach the subathon goal, or the highest subathon milestone goal, it unlocks a future Yshtola cosplay facecam stream. I was preparing that cosplay for FanFest, and so if we do have it, I'll stream as Yshtola. But who knows? Who knows? Maybe we'll get there. Maybe we won't. Who knows? We'll find out on Saturday. Also, the cool things about the subathon is for the incentives. For every one sub, every name gets written on a autograph board that I'm going to be taking to FanFest. Here at FanFest, they usually have like an autograph wall where players can put their names and sign their names on the wall. And so, because there are going to be a lot of folks who aren't able to go to FanFest, I was thinking to put their names on an autograph, my own personal autograph boards, and bring them to FanFest as if, you know, they signed or they're coming to FanFest with us. And then also for every 5 gift subs, keyboard mouse redeems, and you all know I am a controller player. That'll be fun. And then for every 10 subs, karaoke time. I've been practicing. Don't worry. It'll be fun. The best prize? Oh no. Oh man. But I'm really excited for Saturday. I'm really excited. I love doing these streams. I don't do Saturday streams often, but they're really fun. So let's have a blast, everybody. Okay, and then I'll take a break on Sunday after the subathon, regardless of how long that stream is going to be. And then Monday, the 24th, I will be doing a collab stream with Miko Miko Mikyo, who is here in chat right now. We are going to be playing Animal Crossing New Horizons. We are going to be spring cleaning our islands together because it's something we haven't done. So Cat Girls Unite. We're going to be doing all that and hanging out. So feel free to hang out with us, chill with us. It'll be really fun. And then after that, I'm going to be starting my playthrough of Xenosaga 3. Yahoo! Oh, and also thank you for the subscription. Thank you for subbing at tier 1. Oh man. Okay, and I think that's the PowerPoint. I think we did it. Oh my god. Yay, we made it. We did it. Let's go. All right, I'm going to slap. We love a strong PowerPoint. Now go back to the page with all the men. Oh man. Oh. Oh man. Oh Lord have mercy. Wait, do you actually? Oh. Oh. That was scuffed. Okay, I was on the wrong tab. Okay. Oh man. Nothing like a debut stream without scuff, or am I right? Alrighty. Okay. So. I'm going to stop the stream temporarily, and then we're going to start it up to play Cult of the Lamb. Who's ready for Cult of the Lamb? Who's ready? Okay. Congratulations, Girly. Thank you so much on... No, thank you! Thank you, Kieran! Thank you for believing in me. Aww. My god, you all are so sweet. I appreciate it. Okay. So, I will have Cult of the Lamb, the totems, up and running as well. Just have to make sure it's toggled on. Oh, man. Please tell me. And then alerts. Okay, here we go. Resume alerts. Oh god. There it goes. I paused all the alerts. Okay. Congratulations, me. You have a wonderful sign, VTBig. Thank you so much. Thank you. You've worked hard for this. So many alerts, I know, right? Uh-oh, I'm afraid to turn. Oh, there we go. Now you get to all see the lovely alert. Uh-oh. There we go. I was like, oh, they didn't pop up. There we go. I'll have these ready, and then we will swap to Cult of the Lamb. Oh, man. What? Did someone use a spray bottle on me? Thank you so much, everybody. We did it. We've made it through. Strawberry crystals. Hello. Hi, everybody. Oh my gosh. Everybody's here. Huzzah. Okay. Turn this off. Okay. And then I remember how to do this. I remember. Oh, I need to plug in my controller, huh? Okay. Alrighty, I will put my BRB screen up and then end stream and restart stream. So don't go anywhere, everybody. I'll be back.